Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson, good morning, sir.
It is I.
Well, thank you for coming on.
Thanks for your interest.
Season 2, Star Talk, coming up later this month on National Geographic Channel. Which is cool is that you got Season 2 green-lighted even before the first episode aired.
Of the first season, yeah, that was good. No, because they saw the guests and they saw, you know, we had already been recording some of the episodes before they aired, and all the folks at the top of the ladder, they liked what they saw, so we were all very excited about that.
It seems like every week I can read a headline about you, and, you know, recently, the most recent one explaining, you know, how the Bengals beat the Seahawks due to the Coriolis effect.
You know, I just put out the tweet. I don't know who, you know, I don't know who's paying attention. It's an offering to anyone who will read it. But it's real. I mean, I do the calculation. I mean, and I happen to be, here's the thing. I was between two other shows, and I said, let me find, there's probably a football game on, and I'm not really a big, big football, I do it, I watch football socially. And so there's the game, and it's in overtime. And I say, okay, that's got to be interesting.
Yep.
And then I see this kick, and it hits the left goalpost. So I ran the quick calculation, said, yep, rotation of the earth helped that one. And so out came.
So when you watch or witness something, do you immediately snap into, all right, I got to figure out why and how this works?
No, it's not a snap into. It's a state of mind that is on all the time. It's not a, now let me snap into that state of mind. When I look, this is a part of what I think to be educated is to not simply receive information as it comes to you, but process information as you see it. And if you process information, you become a greater participant in not only what is going on, but also in your fate, the fate of anything that happens in your life. So when I'm watching a football game, I'm thinking, oh, he got hit hard. I wonder if he injured his neck or if he did this. Oh, that kick, that's 42 yards. He's got if it angles too far, it'll go to the side. There's an active mind analysis that's going on. And in that way, the world becomes more alive, I think. That's just an opinion.
The next time my wife and I take a trip to Universal Studios, I'm going to let you go with her because she's an engineer and she has that same mindset. So while we were on the rides, I'm over there screaming like a little girl and she's trying to break down. I wonder how they made it happen like that. I'd really love to see how this works.
So I would do both. I would scream and think that.
Perfect. So is there anything then, in your opinion, that can't be explained by science?
So that's an interesting question that I think some philosophers have tackled, and religious people, sort of many, want to orbit that question as a fundamental distinction between what they think and do and what a scientist does. But I can tell you, based on the history of inquiry into things we did not at the time understand, that our success has been so thorough and so systematic that I'm not left with any. All I can say is, if we don't understand it, we just will work a little harder and put more resources behind it, more brain energy behind it, and we'll probably solve it one day. But to say this is unsolvable by the methods of science, the history of inquiry does not support any such claim about anything we currently don't know about.
So I have a very important question for you then. Can you explain with science why exactly Schmonty sucks?
So Neil, the backstory behind this is, this is a popular saying down here in Tucson because in April, I'll give you all the facts and maybe you can come up with some logic behind it. It was in April, it was a hot day at an outdoor concert.
It was a hot day in Arizona? What a rare thing.
Yes, very rare. And I tripped over a power cord, knocking out the sound system to a concert that had about 15,000 people, which led to the chant, Schmonty sucks, which is now lovingly embraced by our listeners here at KFMA.
Okay. So that sounds like a completely legitimate chant, I think. So what you do is, when there's a collective emotion, what I imagine the future of neuroscience would be, if you could do fMRI on the brain, or whatever they call it in neuroscience, where you study what parts of your brain light up when there's stimulus to the brain, and when you're thinking one thought versus another, and when everyone is collectively chanting it, if we notice that it's the same part of everybody's brain lit up, then we've learned something deep about the causes and effects of when someone becomes that's something stupid. So there are ways to probe the human behavior that we're not there yet, but we have people hot on the trail of it.
I'll take it. I will take that. I think I was just scientifically proven that I suck by Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Indeed.
And I'm going to wear that as a badge of honor.
Well, I can prove why everyone agrees that you suck.
So you might not be able to prove that I suck, but why everybody agrees. All right.
Well, yeah, because I'm not saying you do suck. I'm saying people think you suck. And here's the evidence for why. And all the same parts of everyone's brain is lit up. And I think in interpersonal relations, what people think of you, basically, you got to deal with that because this is civilization and society. Unless you move to a desert island on your own, you know, deal with it.
This is by far been one of my favorite interviews ever.
What you do next time? Blame the person who put a cord in the path of someone's foot that is electrifying the stadium of 15,000 people. So there's your clutchiness, but there's also the design of the system that should have preempted that in the first place.
It could have prevented operator error.
Yes, exactly. That's what I.O. means. It's incompetent operator. That's what that means if you have an I.O. problem.
Would you be willing to give me a soundbite saying, you know, I'm Neil deGrasse Tyson, even I can't explain why Schmonty sucks?
I'll try that. Okay. Ready?
Yeah, ready.
Okay. I'm Neil deGrasse Tyson, your favorite astrophysicist, and I've tried, but not even I can explain why Schmonty sucks.
Oh, my God, Neil, I love you forever, man. Thank you so much.
Okay.
And thank you very much for taking the time and calling in to us today.
You got it.